In this video, we are going to talk about circles. Let us see what is a circle. A circle is a locus of a point which moves in such a way that its distance from a fixed point, this is a fixed point, and this is a point, let me change the color, this is a point whose locus we are looking at. The circle is the locus of this point such that it moves at a, it is always at a constant distance from this fixed point, and say that distance is A. So this point will move in this plane R2 in such a way that distance from the fixed point, which is this, is always A. The locus traced, this curve, is called a circle. Therefore, a circle is a locus of a point moving in a plane such that it is always at a constant distance from a fixed point. Correct? Right. This fixed point and this constant distance, these are two important parameters for the circle. This constant distance is called radius of the circle. This is called radius of the circle, and this fixed point is called center of the circle. This is called the center of the circle. Right? Therefore, a circle is the locus of the point which is always at a constant distance from this fixed point. Next thing, I would like to know the equation of the circle. I would like to know what is the equation which is satisfied by the circle. Suppose these are my coordinate axes, rectangular axes. This is x-axis, this is y-axis. And suppose this is the circle, right? And here is the fixed point HK, which is center of the circle. And here is any point on the circle, x comma y. Right? I would like to know an equation which is satisfied by this point x comma y. And I have this information that this distance is always constant, and let us call that constant A. So basically A is the radius of the circle. So let us derive that equation. If this is HK, then it means that this is HK, it means that this is H, this much distance is H, this is the origin O, and this distance is K, right? And this x comma y, it means that this distance, this is x, and this distance, this is y, right? Now let us again change the color. See what is this distance. This is, suppose, my C, center. This is point A, this is point B. I would like to know what is CA. CA is same as, let us call it PQ, because we have this rectangle CAQP. Therefore CA is same as PQ. CA is same as PQ. Now what is PQ? PQ is OQ minus OP. This is OQ minus OP. This is x minus h, right? So I know this CA is x minus h. Now I would like to know what is this AB. What is AB? AB is, you can see, this is BQ minus AQ. BQ minus AQ. Now what is this BQ? BQ is y. And what is this AQ? AQ is same as CP. AQ is same as CP, because we have this rectangle PQAC and opposite sides in the rectangle are equal. Therefore, AQ is same as CP. And what is CP? CP is K. Therefore, AB is Y minus K and CA is X minus K. Now, look at this right angle triangle. We have this right angle triangle. I am drawing this triangle BCA. BCA. I know this is my A. This is this fixed distance A. And AB I have computed. This is Y minus K. And CA I have computed. This is X minus H. And now I will apply Pythagoras theorem in this right angle triangle ABC. Pythagoras theorem tells me that AC square plus BC square is equal to AC square plus AB square is equal to BC square. That is base square plus perpendicular square is equal to hypotenuse square. Right? Therefore, I have this thing X minus H square plus Y minus K square is equal to BC is A square. So, this is the equation of the circle whose center is H comma K and whose radius is A. This is the equation of the circle, equation of the circle whose center is H comma K and radius is A. Now let us look at some special cases. Suppose we are given some special property of a circle, then how this equation will be modified. Okay. Let the origin O be on the circle. The first case is, we are looking at some special cases. This is my equation. I'll remember this equation. The first case is that origin is lying on the circle. The first case is origin is lying on the circle. It means that circle is something like this. This is my origin. So circle is passing through this. Suppose the circle is like this. There are other possibilities as well, but origin is a point on the circle. It means that 0, 0, which is the coordinates of the origin, will satisfy this equation 1. 0, 0 satisfies 1. Right? It means that 0 minus h square plus 0 minus k square is equal to a square. It means that h square plus k square is equal to a square. Therefore, I can write 1 as, I can, now 1 can be written as, 1 can be written as x minus h square. I can open the square, x square plus h square minus 2hk plus y square plus k square minus 2yk. And now I am saying that is equal to a square. And now I am saying that a square is h square plus k square. Therefore, I will replace this with h square plus k square. So, what I will get is, this h square cancels with this h square. And this k square cancels with this k square. So, I have x square plus y square minus 2hk minus 2hx. This is not k, this is x. 2hx minus 2ky is equal to 0. So, this is the equation of the circle when origin is lying on that circle. You don't necessarily need to remember this equation. You can always start with this equation 1. You can always start with this equation 1. And suppose you are given the center, but you are not given the radius. Instead, you are given that your circle is passing through the origin, and you can always compute that a, that will be equal to a square is equal to h square plus k square, and you can always get that equation. But still, it's good if you remember this thing. Second is, let origin be not on the circle. Let origin be not on the circle. But let the center lie on x-axis. But let the center lies on x-axis. In this case, what will happen is, any point on the x-axis, how does any point on x-axis look like? Looks like some h comma 0. So the equation of the circle will be x minus h square plus y minus 0 square is equal to a square. So the equation in this case will be this, right? If your center of the circle is lying on x-axis, then equation will look like this. Next is, let the origin be on the curve. Let origin lies on the circle. And moreover, center lie on x-axis. Center lies on x-axis. What will happen in this case is, we have seen that if center lies on x-axis, then equation will be x minus a square plus x minus h square plus y square is equal to a square. Now, you are saying that origin is lying on this circle. It means that 0, 0 satisfies this equation. It means that 0 minus h square plus 0 square is equal to a square, which says h square is equal to a square. Therefore, I got this equation x minus h square plus y square is equal to h square, which is same as x square plus h square minus 2xh plus y square is equal to h square. This h square cancels, and finally I get this equation x square plus y square minus 2hx is equal to 0. This is the equation when center is lying on the circle and origin is lying on the circle and center is lying on x-axis. Right? Now, if the center is origin, this was case 3. Now let us move to case 4. Case 4 is, if the center coincides with origin. That means you have a circle of this form. This was my x-axis, this was my y-axis, this is your 0, and your center of the circle is this origin. Therefore, your circle will look like this. In that case, you have h is equal to 0, k is equal to 0. Therefore, your equation will be x minus 0 square plus y minus 0 square is equal to a square, which is x square plus y square is equal to a square. This is the equation of your circle in that case. Now, let us look at one last case. Just a minute. Suppose circle touch the axis of x. What does that mean? It means that your circle is something like this. This is your origin, and your circle is touching x-axis, right? And this is the center, h comma k. So if the circle is touching x-axis, what does that mean? That means that this radius is actually the y coordinate of your center of the circle, right? If the circle is touching, suppose circle touches x-axis, the axis of x, it means that the circle is something like this, and this will happen only if this distance is, which is the y coordinate of your center, is equal to radius. This will happen only when k is equal to a, and in that case equation of circle will be, it was, we'll start with this x minus h square plus y minus k square is equal to a square. Now I can replace a square with k square, therefore I have, because I have a is equal to k, so I have x minus h square plus y minus k square is equal to k square. Therefore, equation is x square plus h square minus 2xh plus y square plus k square minus 2yk is equal to k square. This k square cancels. Therefore, equation is x square plus y square minus 2hx minus 2ky plus h square is equal to 0. This is the equation. Now, if your circle is touching y-axis, then we have something like this. A circle will look like this, right? Now, this is your center h comma k. This is possible if and only if this distance, what is this distance? This is actually the x coordinate of your center of the circle, this is equal to a. This is possible only when a is equal to h, similarly as we have explained earlier. So therefore, in this case the equation will be x minus h square plus y minus k square. I'll replace a with h, so I'll get final equation x square minus 2hx plus h square plus y square minus 2ky plus k square is equal to h square. H square cancels, and you get x square minus plus y square minus 2hx minus 2ky plus k square is equal to 0. This is the equation of the circle. Now, next video, we'll look at the general form of the equation of the circle. Thank you.